Hey everyone. Welcome to part 1 of our 3D popping popcorn animation series. I'm Rin, a video creator of the VFX Rendering channel. I will share with you how I make popping popcorn in a pan, using Cinema 4D and Octane. Today, I'm diving into the basics creating models and texturing. Let's get started. First, I will create a corn kernel model using a basic cube, resized down to 10, 5, and 10 centimeters relative to the XYZ axis. Convert the object to a polygon object or press C to make it editable. Reduce the size a little bit. Add some path cuts. And subdivision surface. It looks like a corn kernel now. Now, I switch to UV edit mode to create a UV map for the object. Of course, I have to make it editable first. I delete the default UVW tag to make a new one. This will make texturing easier later. Select and zoom in on the front view area. In the Set UVW from Projection tab, set projection type to frontal. OK. Fit UV to canvas. Now it's done. Return to standard mode. And continue with the popcorn model. At this step, I use a ready-to-use popcorn model because it will save me a lot of time. You can download it free from this website. To import the object into C4D, I simply drag and drop it, and click OK. Choose any popcorn kernel. I choose this one. And split it into a separate object. Move the coordinate axis to the center of the object. Copy and paste the object to the scene I am working on. The proportions look a bit off, zooming in on the popcorn. To make it look reasonable with the kernel. Looks good now. Next, I will remesh the popcorn to make the UVW map. Make it editable. And switch to UV edit mode. In edge selected mode, I choose edges that felt reasonable to me. Okay, hit set UVW from projection and UV unwrap. And see the results. Good, next I will draw the popcorn material. Switch to paint mode. First, click Body Paint 3D Setup Wizard. Only enable the object that needs to be painted. Next. Uncheck Recalculate UV and next. Change color to white. And set texture size to 1024 at min and max values. Finish. Adjusting brush color and size. I create a new layer and draw on it, so as not to affect the original layer. And this is the result. So I got a popcorn texture using paint. Save it. Now move on to making the corn kernel texture. Create an octane material. Now open the node editor. Add gradient node. Then connect it to the diffuse map. Color correction. Select 2DV for type for the correct color gradient. The color position is opposite, so I reverse it. Okay, looks good. Change the material type to glossy. Increase the roughness value a bit to reduce the shine. So I've finished texturing the corn kernel and popcorn. Now move on to create a cast iron pan model. This part, I will do it quickly so as not to waste time. So the pan model is ready. Next, I will set up the lighting. So, in this video, I have created models for the corn kernel, popcorn, and pan as well as textured the corn kernel and popcorn. That's a wrap for part 1. In part 2, I will continue with textures for the pan and the mesmerizing popping animation. Thank you for joining me today. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more exciting videos. Bye!